Hello to dear readers and subscribers of our channel. My name is Igor and I am an expert on plants. Today I'll tell you how to plant and care about climbing roses. As you can understand from the name, the climbing rose, also called crawling, climbs and grows quite long, sets grow quite strong. First of all, you should take care of stakes for climbing. It is desirable to install them before planting. Here we have a simple bamboo frame, but it is mounted in the ground very well. When you choose the planting place, be guided by the sun. The rose is a sun-loving plant, and the climbing one is not an exception. So orientate to the south or southeast for taking a lot of sun, and the plant will be feeling good. The best time for the climbing rose to be planted in a moderate climate is in May or June. Of course, you may plant it in August or September, but it is more risky. Therefore, if you plant it in May or June, you can observe all the processes of development and to see how the rose takes its roots and make some corrections. So, if you buy the container-kept type, you can plant it in the ground even in the summer. Thus, we've bought this container-kept sapling and we will plant it in the summer, actually, right at noontime. It can be done successfully if some rules are kept. Thus, we will dig a hole between these two stakes. The dimensions of the root system are clear, we need about 60 centimeters square. Thus, we have dug a hole. Surely it is better to pour the hole with water properly if you plant in the summer. After this, we strew rich soil mixture on the hole's bottom. Here we have peat, moldy substance, and a little sand. Now the most important is to pull out the sapling from the container. We turn over the container, punch it easily, and then pull the sapling carefully. Shazam! The container is empty and the root system remains solid. White roots are alive and brown ones are dead. It is better for them to be cut out because they won't work in any case. The very important thing before the sapling is standing is to pay attention to the rose roots. They can be its own and can be grafted. As a rule, they are grafted. Our sapling is grafted to briar. As I show, the root's neck needs to be deepened for 2 to 3 fingers thick, actually to this first branch. If we deepen these cultivated grafts, will the root and briar roots not be able to push through such a thick soil layer? So there won't be roots from the briar, but it will grow rose's own strong root system. It is very good. As I said, deepen a little. Soil level is under this lower branch. Now simply strew all the space around our sapling with good rich soil mixture and embed to avoid any pores, and after all these, showering is essential. This showering after planting is necessary for soil for the first to spread compactly, and for all the roots and all the pores to be filled in. After the water is soaked, we additionally strew the upper layer of soil. It is very important to care correctly of the climbing rose after its planting. First of all, it is showering. Such saplings need to be showered every 7 to 10 days with 1 bucket of water. You should not do your utmost because water stagnation is very unpleasant for the rose root system. It starts to fall off. Climbing rose likes additional plant food very much. However, you should not do your most with them after the first year. It would be better to start with them from the second year. You may use liquid dissolved organic plant food, mullein, mull, compost, or complex mineral plant food. Of course, it is better to take care of rose's area, grub up weeds. Moreover, the best way to mulch it is with peat, wooden chip, keramzit, a material that will keep moisture well and won't allow weeds to grow. In addition, the most important thing is proper pruning. You should do sanitary pruning, cutting off dead or disease-suffering branches. Take note that climbing rose blooms only at last year's binds. That is why you should be obligatory saved. Only then will it bloom. One more important factor is winter preparations. Unfortunately, sometimes the rose can be frozen, especially tall ones. That is why when the temperature becomes stable around 5 to 7 degrees below 0 Celsius before the period of strong frosts, you should clip it out from the stakes, bend it down to the ground, you can apply the ground a layer of peat or wooden chips before, and then pin it with wire clips or wooden Y-shaped clips. Then cover it with fir twigs if it is available in your area, or with synthetic agrotextile. It saves your plant from cold perfectly. You may apply several layers if frosts are strong in your region. And then, when the temperature becomes stable above zero and warm, you should take it up and clip it to the stakes. Surely, it is also important to shape the climbing rose correctly. so you should cut off its branches so that they bound off the stake by and by and form some green construction. There it is about climbing rose and its planting and care. Bye-bye to you. Watch our videos and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Have a good one.